we say. They don't like us. And we got to get that same feeling towards them. I mean, right now it's comical to listen to things that are being said. Almost sickens my stomach to turn the TV on because I'm such a proud Canadian and such a fan of our game and very proud of all the players in our locker room. And it makes me ill to hear some of the things that are being said about us. Am I hot? Yeah, I'm hot. Because I'm tired of people taking shots at Canadian hockey. And when we do it, we're hooligans. And when Europeans do it, it's okay because they're not tough or they're not dirty. That's a crock of crap. Our guys sucked it up and they played hard. We outskated them and we're still standing. And believe me, we got a proud bunch in our locker room. And I know the whole world wants us to lose, except for Canada and Canada fans and our players. And we'll be there. We'll be standing.
There you are. It sounds like Coach's Corner. You know, when I heard Red and everything about that after he did that, wearing his heart on his sleeve, you often wonder why a guy gets involved in something like this. There's a guy, no pay, he gets time off, he gets no time off, he's got all the pressure in the world on him, and he gets ripped in the paper. Hey, in the States, it's a gimme. But in Canada, that really hurts when I see stuff like that. It really bothers me when I read like this. This guy told the truth. You know it, I know it, that Kelsa paid for Brampton said it. We don't care about Canada. Rozinski just got through in the paper last night, said, we don't care about Canada. Nobody cares, they don't care about Canada. They want, he comes out, says, you know why it was like that? Because they got it from 10 minutes, they got it right after. He didn't get time to compose himself. So he got carried away. I'm more proud of him now, and think more of him now, than of all his records. That's the guy you saw that got 50 goals in 39 games. That's the guy, when he's hurt, he plays. That's the guy that sticks up for Canada. He also said, I live in the States. He says, but I'm a Canadian. This guy's a Canadian and he gets ripped by Canada. It's the old story, Canada eats his own. All you people that are down on him there should be wrong. You're wrong, because he's right. He knows what's going on in hockey. I know what's going on in hockey. We've been in the pits.
Well, you know what you both are? You're at the top. And that's he was under a lot of stress, no doubt about it. As you say, I don't think he really wanted a suspension. In fact, the next morning you saw him, he was a bit, you know, Wayne. He's kind of apologetic, but he's 40. He got fed up. He just got fed up.
Well, you get fed up. Everybody takes shots at us in the world. It's bad enough everybody else all over the world hates us. Then we get it at home. Can't be for once if you stand up for Canada. Every person that stands up for Canada, is he always wrong in our country? Why? I don't understand.
Well, because we are a multicultural country, and we try to be, look at, no, don't roll your eyes, but we try to be leaders in terms of peacekeeping and a lot of things that are good and noble, and we don't brag too much.
No, we should brag. We should stand up for our country. We should do all stuff like that. Wayne did it. I'm saying it right now. I think more of him now. Oh, Bobby Orr.
I do too.
All right, wait a minute, all right. I talked to Bobby Orr this morning. He said Wayne was so carried away and he meant every word. That wasn't a shill thing to get the team going. He almost had tears in his eyes. If this guy wears his heart in his sleeve, he's a true Canadian. We should all be proud of him. And that's all I've got to say for it now.
All right, you're right on the money, God. That's the best I'd ever seen him. And as I say, he's top puppy, so they're going to cut him off.
Let's go. I don't know what's
going on. We've got a bit of time here. What? So, just so you know, we got a bit of time here.
All right, now, I don't know what's going on with these pucks out here. And I don't know what's going on with these ice. By the way, the referee is making this game. This is the way a game should be ref. No chintzy stuff so he can get himself, you know, on TV. And this guy, look, Denny LaRue's doing a good job. American, I hate to say it. Anyhow, let's watch Owen Nolan when he's got the puck. This has been happening all the time. Watch it. Could cost us a goal. Watch it coming up. He comes out of his end. Watch the puck bounce right off. Bounce right off his stick. He can't hold it. It's been going on and on the whole time. So watch for that. And now we got Brodeur. He's standing tall right now. I don't like this one goal, though, boy. I'm really bothered me. One goal. They're sucking a lot.
Shots 14 to 5. That's too many.
15 to 5. By the way, they're ready. They love this here. They're the way they're going. Anyhow, watch Brodeur. He's in a groove right now. Watch when he blocks a shot where he puts it over in the corner now. Comes to the point. Guy puts it on the net. Puts it right over in the corner. Makes a shot. Oh. What's with that one?
This is the corner one. That one was actually...
Yeah, look at that. Right over in the corner.
is the best player on the ice on either side, and they were worried about this guy being a
gambler and everything. He's the best guy on the ice right now.
What about Sakic?
Oh, well, Sakic's doing pretty good too, but Jovanovski, to me, is the best player on the ice right now.
Okay, Don Cherry on the coach's corner on behalf of Wayne, and who could blame you? That was
Just a minute. A lot of people say, look at him sucking up to Gretzky. Not a chance. I've always said Bobby Orr's the best, and I've been kind of giving it to him for all along. He's a good Canadian, and everybody should be proud of him.
And he dresses to the nines. Not a bad thing.
Coach's Corner with Don Cherry. Brought to you by BF Goodrich Tire. Proud to cheer on Canadian athletes.